The tip gazed Mary's chest as it passed by. She didn't feel like she'd evaded it. Her right eye had simply told her the sword's path. Her body had moved on its own. The left side of her body slowly turned. Her left leg naturally took one step forwards. The distance between them shrunk even more. Charlie's face was right next to her. She screamed. The pain in her right hand intensified. She clenched it without thinking. She clenched empty space. Her right hand grasped black, which should have been nothing in that moment. Her right hand vanished, the space sinking like a black marsh swallowed up Mary's right hand. Black, black, deep. Deaths, perhaps stagnant dregs, impure darkness. In that place, inside her clenched right hand, something was born. Something sharp was pulled out. A black sword. The same as Charlie's. This should have been the fourth time she'd held it. She wrung out her will to stop it, but her body moved, thrusting the tip forwards. The sensation of easily tearing apart space ran through her body, along with chills and an urge to vomit. Mary felt strong pain in her right hand. She groaned slightly, had hurt so much she thought she might scream if she let her voice out. The tip of her sword pointed towards Charlie's chest. They were extremely close, but space expanded. Her sense of equilibrium shook, but she knew she hadn't stepped backwards. Space expanded. The distance between Mary and Charlie grew all on its own. The opposite of Charlie's sword, she thought that in a corner of her mind as it grew hazy from pain. The sword gave birth to several thorns that wrapped around and pierced Mary's hand. Pain, much stronger than the pain of being stabbed by a needle. The black sword withered. Many, many thorns rose up out of it. Strong pain, severe shaking. It hurt, it hurt, it hurt, however. She swung her black sword toward Mary, too fast for her left eye to keep up. At the same time, her right hand moved, as if pulled along by the thorns around it. She could hear it clearly even without clearing her ears. It was laughter. The loud voice of him laughing, ridiculing as he looked down on the two of them from his throne. Even though she couldn't see his face, Mary could tell.
ハハハハハ剣と剣、人と人。人は決してそれを止めることができない。滑稽かな滑稽かな。猿の末に立ってなお剣は交わされる。これがあなたの見たかったものか。こんなもののために世界を売り渡したか。
In the unlit black, in the darkness of Sharnoth, a strange masked man spoke to someone. Even though no one was there, there was nothing there at all. But after a short while, one voice answered, the lone king's words answered.
Tamare.
Meari! Watashino kawaii! Meari Clarissa! Onegai yo! Mou akiramete choudai!
The swords hit each other. At the same time, his laughter echoed around them. She kept hitting it, she kept hitting it, but the black sword kept swinging without a single chip. The thorns controlled her hand, stopping her sword. Were they doing that because Mary wished them to, or were the thorns moving all on their own? Her voice shook, her body was also shaking. She had a very clear hunch that she couldn't hold the sword any longer, that she couldn't let the laughter at the throne continue. However, her hands wouldn't let go, the thorns were wrapped around her. Countless thorns ate into her right hand, piercing through her, but no blood at all flowed out, the black thorns just sank into her skin. Each time one pierced her, she felt like vomiting, each time one pierced her, she felt more disgust, she couldn't bear it. But she couldn't let go. She couldn't let go, even though she knew she couldn't hold onto it. The pain prevented her If she moved, she would be assaulted by even greater pain. That hunch made Mary shake.
Charlie! Charlotte! Listen to me!
Even though the pain intensified with each swing, her hand swung the black sword without letting go. And every time it did, his laughter echoed.
人の生み出した最も優れたものの一つ。互いを駆逐し合うためのもの。愚かにも儚くももろく小さき人間たちが自らを減らし続けるための自滅の道具。それを手放すことができなかったがゆえに人はシャルノスを求める。そして、それは誰も抗うことはできない。我が輩は、俺は、私は、そう信じている。だが、もしも、脆弱な人の中でたった一人が抗うことを可能としたなら。
In the unlit black, in the darkness of Sharnoth, a strange masked man spoke to someone. Even though no one was there, there was nothing there at all. But after a short while, one voice answered, the Lone King's words answered.
黙れ。
The black blades clashed, their hearts clashed, they scattered sparks as they tore apart space. She could hear laughter. She could hear laughter. Laughter echoed loudly around them each time they crossed blades.
邪魔をしないで、お願いよ。どうして私たち二人もう怯えて泣くこともないのに、もう悲しむこともないのに、あなたと一緒に、メアリー。
Their swords clashed violently. They gazed at each other while poised to strike. She wasn't trying to put strength into her blows. Nonetheless, the two blades shook violently.
I said, Sari. Two is not bad. I promised. I and you. I'm going to see you on the other
side of the Sari. I'm going to see you. 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 I'm going to see you.あなたは剣を止めてくれないの。辛くてたまらない。こんなにも痛む。手はもう感覚さえないほど。
私は諦めたの、メアリー。あなた以外のすべてを。だから、あなたも諦めて。
いや、いや、いやよ。私は誰のことも諦めたりしない。あなたも、アーセのことも、誰のことも。
She spoke. She focused her mind on her right hand. She focused and swung harder. She pushed her sword forwards with all her strength, strongly, strongly, as her vision warped with pain, strongly, strongly, biting her lower lip to endure it. The crossed sword flew. Charlie's sword flew. Her right eye told her Charlie had stepped back. It taught her the muscles to swing her sword with towards her chest.She didn't know anything about fighting, she didn't know anything about swords, but she understood.
視界の端に何かうごめくものが見えた気がして、今だと胸の内で叫ぶ声が聞こえる。
The voice sounded like her own. Now, if you do it now, you can pierce. Charlie. His laughter became louder, His whispering voice reached her from Charlie's lips.Charlie's eyes shook as they gazed at her, her golden eye and her original green eye.
私は見た。チャーリーの目元に溜まった雫。ああ、それはずっと見ていなかったものだった。あなたの涙。
チャーリ
ー! That instant.
Nori に蘇る記憶があった。幼い頃、ずっとずっと以前のこと、もう明瞭には思い出せなくなったほどの昔、幼い頃、ブロンテ家の庭で、二人でたくさんのことを話した。恋のこと、母のこと、勉強のことも、学校のことも、日に日に増えていく友達のことも、そして、明日のことも。
シャーリー、そんなに心配しないで。大丈夫よ。もしも世界が二人だけになっても全然大丈夫。シャーリーのことはメアリが守るから。メアリは大丈夫、強いもの。 王子様の代わりにだってなるくらい強いのよ。男の子にだって負けないんだから。ママがいなくても泣いたりしないわ。だから大丈夫ね、シャーリー。
そう、こんなことをよく話した。シャーリーはいつも何かを怖がっていて、その度に私はシャーリーの手に触れて。
心配しないでね。怖くないわ。神様にたくさん明日をもらおう。一緒だもの。何も心配いらないわ。素敵なことたくさんしよう。勉強もたくさん、お菓子もたくさん。それでね、大人になって夢を叶えるの。
夢？
うん、そう、夢。立派なレディーになって、ママと同じくらい綺麗になって、素敵な王子様と恋して、美味しいものもたくさん食べて、結婚して、子供は4人産んで、それにそれに、うん、お話も書くわ。私いつか絵本を書くの。素敵なもの全部絵にするの。絵本にするの。素敵なもの全部シャーリーにもママにもみんなに教えてあげるのよ。
すごいわメアリー。書いたお本私読んでもいい？
一番にあなたに見せるわ。約束よ。
ええ、約束。
ほら、約束したわ。だからもう大丈夫。約束したこと、ちゃんと神様が見ているもの。だから失敗いらないわ、シャーリー。
でも、何か怖いことあったら。
大丈夫。言ったでしょ、シャーリー。いざとなったら、メアリが怖いの全部やっつけるわ。シャーリーのことはメアリが守るから。だから大丈夫。